Okay, I'm going to walk you through a detailed example first. And then we have several homework assignments for you to do. For each of the homework assignments, if you push show answer, you will be given access to a video that Maggie has made that actually walks you through how she would do the proof by induction. One thing that's really important when you do a proof by induction is that you write things down very clearly and that you actually justify your steps. Let's have a look at a very simple example. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use mathematical induction to prove this fact right here. If n is greater than or equal to 1, then the sum from I equals 0 to n minus 1 of I is equal to n times n minus 1 over 2. Now remember, the sum I equals 0 to n minus 1 of I is just 0 plus 1 plus dot 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 plus n minus 1. So we're just summing the first n non-negative integers. I'm picking this particular example not only because it's relatively simple, but also because we're going to see this particular summation when we analyze the cost of various operations next week. How do you prove this? Well, you start with the base case. Okay? You set n equals 1, and you state, what is it that I need to show? And what it is that you need to show, you get from simply taking this expression and plugging in n equals 1. This is what you get. Write it down. The way I like to do this, I'd like to say what it is that I have on the left on this equality and where it is that I would like to get so that I can keep my eye on where we need to go. And the first step here is to simply say, well, the definition of the sum from I equals 0 to 1 minus 1 of I is just the sum from I equals 0 to 0, and that just means that I'm adding 0 to absolutely nothing else. So we get 0. I give a justification for that. That simply comes from the definition of summation. Now, this is where we want to be. From basic arithmetic, you recognize that if multiplication has 0 in it, somehow it evaluates to 0. And therefore, we know that by basic arithmetic, the result is true. So now we know that the base case is true. The next thing you do is you clearly state what it is that the inductive hypothesis is. Okay? You assume that the result is true for some n equal k, and then you want to show it's true for n equals k plus 1. Okay. What I like to do is I like to clearly then state what that means. The result being true for n equals k means that this here is true. All that I've done is I've replaced n by k in the expression. And what it means for n equals k plus 1 for the property to be true, I state right here. And again, all I've done is I've replaced every occurrence of n with k plus 1. What I want to show is that this is true if I assume that that is true. How do we do that? We start by stating the left-hand side of what it is that we're trying to prove. And we state what the right-hand side is because that's where we want to get. Then we start chipping away at the proof. The first thing I do is some arithmetic where I recognize that k plus 1 minus 1 is just k. The next step is to say, well, my inductive hypothesis tells me something about if I only sum k terms. So what I want to do is I want to take this summation and I want to separate out the last term. And I get this. We call that splitting off the last term. Now I can invoke my inductive hypothesis because I know that this is equal to that. So now I'm left with having to prove that this is equal to that. That should be just basic algebra. Now I start working backwards. I can take this expression and simplify it to that expression. And that's just, well, that's really algebra, right? And then I can take this expression and show that it's equal to that expression. That's again algebra. And finally, I can recognize that this is equal to that. And now I have shown that this is equal to that, 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 and therefore, by transitivity of equality, this result is equal to that result. So that proves the inductive step. And then all I need to do is say, by the principle of mathematical induction, the result holds for all n. And I'm done. Mathematical induction is a very powerful proof technique. You should take this opportunity to really master it. In order to master it, what you need to do is first to practice, practice, practice. And this is why we give you homework exercises. The other thing you want to do is you want to be very organized in your proofs. Nobody is going to believe your proof if you have things written all over a piece of paper. So what you want to do is take out a piece of paper, sketch out what the proof by induction should be like. Then what you want to do is take out a clean piece of paper and rewrite the entire proof all over again so that everything is nicely organized. In particular, you need to pay close attention to the fact that Maggie is very organized in her answers in the homeworks. Now notice that Maggie has had a lot of practice, and therefore she can write things down from top to bottom as one nice proof, nicely organized, etc., etc. Eventually, you will gain enough experience that you too can do that.